first speaker is Dr. Michael Dillon, who is a family physician practicing in downtown Winnipeg. And he has been working with newcomer refugees for almost 20 years and was a real impetus in putting together today's events and linking up physicians and health professionals from across the country. Mike, are you out there? Let's hear from Dr. Mike.
Gracias. Merci beaucoup. Bienvenue. Welcome to everyone. Thank you for coming out. It's overwhelming to see the kind of support, enthusiasm, kindness, and generosity that is evident out here today. Those of us who helped organize this are joining with our colleagues from coast to coast to coast. We have unprecedented support from many organizations across the country, and I think most important, it's amazing to see the kind of support that we're getting from the community of caring people who live in Winnipeg and Manitoba, the heart of the country. Winnipeg. I've been a family doctor for about 25 years. I trained in a newcomer community in Toronto, and I was welcomed into the downtown Winnipeg community where I've been loving practicing for the past 17 years or so. Over that time, we have a very special place in our hearts for newcomers, immigrants, and refugees, people who come from the most vulnerable and dangerous parts of the world. We've been working together with our colleagues in the settlement community, in Welcome Place, in communities across the province, in trying to provide good quality care. We're joining today in an unprecedented way with doctors' organizations from coast to coast, including the Canadian Medical Association, the College of Family Physicians of Canada, the Royal College of Physicians and Surgeons of Canada, University of Manitoba Department of Family Medicine, the Canadian Pediatric Society, the Canadian Psychiatric Association. Listen, we're doctors. We never agree this much. That never happens. In addition, we have the invaluable support of our allied health professionals, the Canadian Pharmacists Association, the Canadian Dental Association, the Canadian Association of Optometrists, the Canadian Nurses Association, the Canadian Association of Social Workers. So if you represent those communities, shout out, please. Thank you. The Canada that we see as a generous society, that's the Canada that it must remain. Our values include equitable health care for all Canadians, from Aboriginal communities who've been here for millennia to the newcomers who've been here for a couple of weeks. We have to share that generosity with everyone. The federal cuts to the interim federal health program, which provides care for newcomers wherever they arrive in Canada, must not be cut. We must tell the governments not to do this.